rebrand them, and it's not clear if any Wilko staff will be retained. You are live with BBC News. Now, the North Korean leader Kim Jong-un is believed to be on his way to Russia to meet Vladimir Putin. The armoured train that Mr. Kim uses for foreign visits has reportedly left Pyongyang, and the Kremlin has confirmed Mr. Kim will visit Russia in the coming days. It will be his first international trip in more than 4 years. The leaders are expected to discuss the possibility of North Korea providing Russia with weapons to support its war in Ukraine. Now, the Professor of Russian Politics at King's College London and Senior Analyst at the Centre for European Policy Analysis, Samuel Green, joins me now from Washington. Hello to you. Thank you so much for joining us. So tell us about this meeting. Would this be expected?
Well, this has been in the works for a while. We've known, and Western intelligence has been showing, even either side has been hiding the fact that there have been some flows of armaments, low-level flows and pretty basic stuff from North Korea to Russia for quite some time now. The Russian Defense Minister, Sergei Shoigu, recently was in Pyongyang, where he was feted, and they talked about this this growing relationship. This has been telegraphed now for the last several days, at least, that there was going to be a trip to Russia and likely a meeting between the two leaders. I think it's reflective of, something that's not surprising, which is that Russia doesn't have a lot of friends. And so it needs to get a little bit closer at the moment to those who are willing to do business with it.
Samuel, what do you think the two sides want from each other?
I think there's at least two things going on, one of which is pragmatic, right? So Russia does want arms, and North Korea is in a position to provide at least some support in that regard. North Korea wants technology, and there's certainly a lot of technology, particularly for its missile programs, that Russia can provide. But I think there's also a symbolic and a political element to this, which is that, I think Moscow is trying to send a signal to the West about exactly how far it is willing to go in causing trouble around the world. The U.S. and Europe are rightly concerned about nuclear nonproliferation and about the role that North Korea plays in the world. And Russia is, I think, demonstrating that it is willing to actually help North Korea become more of a problem for the West, unless the West is willing to do a deal in Ukraine.
I mean, do you think a lot of people will be concerned about the nuclear issue? Do you think that's going to be something that the two leaders will be discussing?
Well, the reality is we're not going to get an accurate, readout or a press conference at the end of the summit. So I don't want to make too many predictions about what they will be discussing, but it will be certainly on the minds of Western leaders, and rightly so. Right? Nonproliferation is a serious issue. North Korea is a difficult player in the world, and one that the U.S., certainly, and its allies in Japan and South Korea are very, very worried about. And so the implications of this are serious. On the other hand, I'm not sure that translates into a willingness to give Russia what it wants in Ukraine.
Okay, Samuel Green, we will have to leave it there. Thank you, Samuel Green, Professor of Russian Politics at King's College London. Now, here in the UK, Britain's Home Secretary